feel like we made a bit of a meal of that one.
Well, the win CSR white wings just rolls off the tongue, doesn't it?
Get behind it, though. Now, dessert queen Kirsten Tibbles set the ultimate pressure test for three strong MasterChef women last night, Julie, Billy and Mindy. In the end, the native food queen Mindy's time was up and she was sent home. But she joins us now live from gorgeous Byron Bay. Mindy, it's so gorgeous to see you.
Oh, Jingiwala. Oh. Welcome to Byron Bay Cabin Bar, this beautiful place on the north coast of New South Wales. How lucky am I to be home?
We're lucky to be talking with you this morning. Top seven, wow, that is an incredible achievement. You came to MasterChef to showcase Indigenous Australian ingredients and food. You must be pretty proud of what you've done.
Oh, what an experience and what an opportunity to really showcase what native food is all about. You know, native food for us is not just an ingredient, it's not just food, it's about connecting culture and country. Of course, that beautiful, rich history that First Nations Australia has. So it was an incredible experience and I loved it. Every minute of it, I loved it.
Beautifully said. Today we're very lucky to have you showcase some of those native ingredients. First of all, what are you making and showcasing for us this morning?
Well, check it out. I don't know what kind of bush tucker that you fellas have tried before, but this is one of our absolute favourites. Check it out. This is saltbush. There's about 60 different varieties of saltbush throughout Australia. This is kind of one of my favourites. It's called Old Man Saltbush. So this might be one for you, Bo. Yeah. Old Man Saltbush. It's delicious. It's beautiful for the environment because it actually sucks a lot of that salt out of the soil, which is great for stabilising nutrition and health of our soil and getting all that salt out of our environment. And it also tastes really good. You know, our First Nations ancestors used to actually use this as a fire retardant too. So planting saltbush around and making those seeds, dropping them throughout the environment meant that they could stop bushfires with this stuff. I mean, how clever were they? Absolutely brilliant. So I want to showcase exactly what this plant is all about today. Beautiful salty flavours. I'm going to make a really light little batter with something super simple. We're just going to make plain flour, a little bit of sparkling water. And that's going to make a really light batter. We're going to crispy up this saltbush and give you a real taste of what country is all about. Good. Have you fellas tried saltbush before?
I've tried it before. No. I've tried it before. I was in the jungle with Derek Kickett, an proud Indigenous man. He introduced it to me about 6 months ago. But, I'm late to the party with native ingredients. I'm all ears here.
Well, you know, it's got a rich history. They're the oldest ingredients in the world. 60,000 years worth of cooking, looking after, nourishing and learning about all these ingredients. And that's what it's all about. It's not just using it as food. It's understanding that our ancestors really understood what these plants were about, the medicinal qualities. We've got warrigal greens. We've got bloodlimes, finger limes, kujera, these gorgeous little things here.
Finger limes.
Have a guess to what they might be.
They look like it may be a what do you think they berry?
Is it a prune or something?
Yeah.
What is it, Mindy? Well, the traditional name for these little guys is actually called kujera, but they are our native tomatoes. Can you believe that's an Australian native tomato? Straight out of the bush, tiny. It's really reflective of the environment it comes from because, of course, dry, arid conditions means tiny little fruit, but loaded full of nutrients and absolutely delicious in flavour. So I've made a little bush tomato mayo that's going to go with our crispy saltbush. We're going to break off those beautiful little leaves, dip them in that and have some good feed. How does that sound?
That sounds awesome.
Just need to get you fellas up to Byron Bay so you can try it, huh?
Love Byron. We just can't afford any rental accommodation up there. We're waiting for prices to go down. Hey, Mindy, I want to talk about last night. I watched
Come and stay with me, Bo. No excuses.
I'll hold you to that. Hey, we watched last night and it was a wonderful episode. Unfortunately, you left. But it was very emotional. You guys seem very close, especially the three girls at the end. You're very tight-knit, like sort of like a family, aren't you?
Oh, Bo, food's all about family and connection, as you know. And when you're away from your family, your mob, for 6 months, you get very tight bonds with each other. We had a lot going on, you know. Back at home, we had floods, we had rain, we had stuff going on with our family. So we really relied on each other to pull us through that crazy time. And those friendships and those bonds will honestly last a lifetime.
Oh, well, the MasterChef experience, just for the meantime, might be done for now, but what's next for you, Mindy?
Yes.
Well, babe, I'm back on the pans. You know, I'm in my beautiful little restaurant, Kakala in Byron Bay. I'm revamping the menu. They've got me working hard in the kitchen. And my next plan is to get these amazing native foods into every primary school throughout Australia. You know what I mean? The kids are our future. I want to connect them to this rich history, these amazing foods. They're good for us, they taste good, and they're part of our country and culture. So I want to get these foods into all those beautiful primary schools throughout Australia so we can really start embracing these for the future.
Oh, Mindy, we love what you do. Thank you so much for chatting with us today. Look how good looks.
Anything fried's great, isn't
it? Right.
Here we go. I mean, isn't it? Check that out. I mean, this is a real taste of the country. What we're going to do, we're just going to put this on our beautiful little plate. We don't even need to salt it because it's got that natural saltiness to it.
Yeah.
Got our little mayonnaise on the side, and there is our crispy salt bush. A beautiful taste of country.
Oh, we love that, Mindy. Thank you again. We'll come and see you in Byron soon.
Boogle Bear, thanks so much, guys. Yahweh.
Bye. And don't forget, MasterChef Australia fans versus fans and favourites continues tonight at 7:30 on 10 and 10 Play on demand. Don't miss it.